I am Dr. Chintamanika Saira, a senior oncologist. I am consultant at Uday Omni from the inception, and I take care of almost all the cancer patients coming here. And we have a very good team, supporting team, to take care of all related matters. So I am happy to treat cancer patients in this tertiary care cancer center. Yeah, elderly population is more susceptible to get cancers. That's why geriatric population, if they present with a lump, the chances of that lump being malignancy is almost 1 in 3. Whereas pediatric population, having lump diagnosed as cancer is 1 in 7th. So most of the times it is geriatric population or aging population which have more cancers incidence wise. And cancer is the second commonest cause of death all over the world, and in some countries it is the first common cause of death all over the world. Like most of the parts of the world, it is cardiovascular disease which is the major cause of death, but in some countries it is cancers have surpassed that one. And but on the whole, it is second commonest cause of death all over the world after cardiovascular disease. Yeah, it starts with simple mutation of the cell, normal cell, which loses its function of whatever it has been doing. Like say salivary gland. Salivary gland cells are supposed to produce saliva. Instead of doing its activity, the activity of malignant cell is to multiply itself, invade the cells, other cells, normal cells, stop its own duty, means of producing saliva and all, or whatever it's a main function, and it starts invading other tissues, and it multiplies more rapidly than the normal cell. And over a period of time, it loses its normal cell architecture of that particular cell, and it becomes more virulent. This is how the cell develops into a malignant cell. Most of the cancers are non-contagious, but like say for example cervical cancer, husband marries some other lady, that other lady can also get cervical cancer. So except for that sexual transmission of this cervical cancer, most of the cancers are not contagious. Yeah, there are a lot of vaccines available for cancer, like human papilloma virus vaccine is available for cervical, head and neck cancers, and hepatitis B vaccine is available for hepatitis, like that. Other vaccine trials are also going on for like prostate cancer and some other cancers. But as on now, human papilloma virus vaccination and hepatitis B vaccination are the major vaccines available for cancers. Other vaccines, therapeutic vaccines are on trial, like BCG vaccine is used for urothelial bladder cancers. They are in situ cases, they seem to work. Like that for prostate and other malignancies also, soon a lot of trials are going on. We would be getting them once the FDA approves them. India. Most common cancer in India is head and neck cancers. Usually about 25% of cancers in India are head and neck cancers. But all over the world, if you see, it is lung cancer. So lung cancer, breast cancer, cervical cancer, these are gastrointestinal cancers, these are few of the common cancers. But most of the time it is, like for India, if you see, head and neck cancers, cervical cancers are more than the rest of the world population. If you see the rest of the world, we have lung cancer as the commonest cancer and breast cancer as the commonest cancer. But in India, we see, apart from those, we see this of having almost 1 lakh women dying of cancer in per year, whereas in the world, whole world, five lakh people die. Means of 1/5 of them are from India itself. So also this head and neck cancers are highest in the world. Yeah, if you see, male preponderance is there for most of the cancers. So also for cancers in general. But females also get cancer, children also get cancer. So they also get, but little more preponderance is there in males than females. Yeah, early stages there are no signs and symptoms. That's why screening is the must. By the time the woman gets cancer, the tumor would have already become stage 3 or 4 to get signs and symptoms of cancer. Because in early stages, there won't be any symptoms or any signs. So that's why we encourage women above 45 to get or 50 to get a mammosonography. So this mammosonography picks up early lesions like stage 1 cancers, where the survival rates are almost more than 90%. So we should not wait for signs and symptoms to develop to screen a woman. Screening is testing a normal woman without any signs and symptoms. This is what our aim is. So we should not wait, because if we lose that opportunity, when the patient lands in stage 3 or 4, the results are very poor. It's almost less than half of what is normally seen. So it will be around 50% whole breast cancer put together. But if you see stage 1, it is almost more than 90%. So we'll be making curable malignancies to incurable malignancies. So we should do the screening as per the guidelines of that particular, like say for most of the times people follow American Society of Clinical Oncology guidelines. So we have to follow mammosonography after 50 years like that. So the 274 or 75, so that we detect the cancers in early stage and treat them. Tumor is any growth. Any growth is labeled as a tumor. Like say for example, mole is a tumor. Birthmark, they are a tumor. Malignant melanoma is a cancer. So wart is a tumor. Cancer is, tumor includes benign and malignancy. But malignancy, cancer is the layman's terminology for epithelial tissues. Like sarcomas are the malignancies of connective tissue, blood, connective tissues. So these have to be, these are the layman terminologies. Yeah, most of the cancers can be cured actually. If you see the cancer curability rate, if you see, it's almost 80% in most of the countries. So the dictum is early, screening, preventive measures like vaccinations, avoiding tobacco, alcohol, all coloring agents, pollutants, and what all the carcinogens we know of, and detecting them early and giving the best form of treatment. This is the dictum. And if you see, in most of the world, it's almost 80% of the cancers can be curable or treated, can be cured. So this is depends upon what cancer screening modalities they adopt.